get into it, man. I want to welcome y'all. You know, I got something new for y'all. You know what I mean? I'll be presenting a story time for y'all. Man. You know, a lot of people online be doing stuff like this, but me, I'm a little different. I got a little different type of shot zone, a little different type of speed. You know what I mean? So we just gonna be vibing out with these stories. You know, a lot of these stories is gonna be painful stories, funny stories, you know, but for the most part, it's something that we can take away from it, to learn from, you know, and, yeah, my life is really different, man. You know, so, I just want to put these stories out full detail, you know, because I'm inspired by people that do audiobooks. I love audiobooks, listening to people tell their stories, so, I feel like, why not get some people to fill them out, you know, if you're from New York, from the East Coast, definitely gonna rock with these stories and definitely gonna fill them. But I'm gonna also try to explain the stories to where if you're from LA or Paris or wherever, you're gonna feel me too, you know? But this story right here, we gonna call this MSN. Now, and when I say MSN, I mean like the app. Like, a lot of y'all are too young for that. Like, y'all wasn't there. You feel me? Like, you feel me? Like, I'm about to be 30, so you, Yahoo, AIM, BBM, like, a lot of y'all wasn't there for that. You know what I mean? So, I'm talking for the people that know, like, you know, you young boys might have to, you know what I mean? Stay tight. But, yeah, man, this is back when I was in, like, 7th, 8th grade. I went to my 11, you know what I mean? And it was a little middle school. Pretty much it was in, I guess you could say it was in East Flatbush or Canarsie. Like, it was on the cusp, like right on the, I guess you could say it was in Canarsie, you know? And, IS-285. You know, we had a mean ass principal named Miss Holder, you know? But a lot of the teachers was cool. Me, like, I was a good kid in school. Like, I wasn't the smartest, but I damn sure never was the dumbest. You get what I'm saying? I wasn't the class clown, but, like, I'll crack my jokes and be at the pool table too, though. You know what I mean? So, I'm one of them. Always come through. I'm dressing pretty decent. You know, like, I had one little flaw, but we're going to get into that for another. I'm going to say that for another story time. You know what I mean? But I was good. Now, again, it was a middle school. So, you know, you go from 6th, 7th to 8th grade. Now, I believe on my, I don't know if it was 7th or 8th. I believe on my 8th grade year, a lot of new students came in. I didn't really understand why or where they was coming from, but a lot of new students came in. You know, so there was these two students in particular. One named Angel. And another young brother that go by the name of Javier. Now, Angel, keep in mind, both of these young brothers are Hispanic. At the time, I don't know if they're Dominican, I don't know if they're Puerto Rican. Looking back, I think they were Dominican. Angel, because I gotta describe these guys. Angel was like, always hype, like, he wasn't hyper, but, like, he was hyper. Like, this kid would come to school showing us magic tricks. Like, he was one of them bulls. Like, he know how to do magic tricks and shit. Like, he'll pull out his pocket, and then he'll, like, his pocket will go back into his pants. Like, he'll do stuff like that. Hide a quarter, make it reappear. Like, he was that bull. So, he'll just run around excited, showing people things, shit like that. Now, Javier, let me tell you about Javier. Javier, this nigga was mad brolic. Like, for a fucking 8th grader, like, you know, this nigga's more in shape back then than what I am now. Like, the nigga was stocky, man. And it wasn't, like, stocky as in big brolic, but it was just, he was bigger than us, my nigga. Like, for sure. You know what I mean? And he was fairly decent, probably like 6 feet, 5'11". At the time, we're all like 5'5", 5'6", 5'7". You know what I mean? So for him to be the new, and the nigga was fly. Like, yo, and 08, 07, 09, you know what was in? Niggas was fucking with the Griffies. Niggas was fucking with the ACG. Yo, this nigga had like 5 different color ACGs, bro. And you know, at that time, like, nigga had like 3 different pair of Griffies, bro. You feel me? Different fitted, like you got a fitted what? You know what I'm saying? Different flavors. That was him. You feel me? Now again, I'm one of them niggas. Again, I'm not top 5, but I'm top 20. Like I'm just, you know what I mean? That was some, I always been like that for me. In elementary, in middle school, and in high school. In high school, got even more real. I was like top 10, you know what I mean? Top 5 now, high school, you know what I mean? So, but yeah. So you know how it is. A cool kid gonna gravitate to a cool kid, you know? So, Javier pull up, I get cool, Javier cool, me, you know what I mean? Robin. Angel get cool with Javier get cool, you know? They Dominican, they talking their little language, they Javier. Now, here's the thing now. So when we would have lunch, the lunchroom was divided by, so you had to sit with your homeroom. Some of my niggas, it might be called your crew cloud, like, but you had to sit with your homeroom. So if you, it went from 7:01 to 7:23. So every lunch table had their own assigned number. You got 7:01 over there, 7:02 over there, 7:02. Now, the way it is, the lunchroom had different entrances and exits, but the way we typically would enter into the lunchroom, it's like you're coming in by the 723 area. It's like the lower the number, the further you have to walk to the table. So you're coming in from the top, start from 723. That's the entrance. This part don't really matter, but I'll tell you anyway. So when I first started that school, I was in 623. And I forgot to mention this to you guys. So the higher the number also dictates the level of your academic level. So if we were in 623 or 7, like, because every year it changes, 623, 723, 823, you're going to 8th grade. So if you are in the 23s, that was the smartest class. 23 and 22 were the smartest classes. 21 was like the A class. 22 and 23 are like A plus. 20 into like 17 was like the B plus. Like, you know, they're still good. Anything after that is like the regular kids. So when I came into the school, I was at 623. I was always, my lunch table was the 23s. In 7th grade, I became a 21. It's the 7th and 8th grade, I became a 21. So that just go to show where academically I was good, but I wasn't like, again, like I'm the kid, I'm still chilling with the cool kids. I'm barely doing my homework. I'm doing it just to get by. Like, I'm, you know, so that was that, you know, something small I figured I should share with you guys, you know. So we're at the 21 table for lunch every day. Now, you know, we young kids. We very impressionable. Lil Wayne is out. Some of us want to be Blood. Some of us want to be Crip. Like some of the dudes that was claiming Crip in the school around that time, like they really was from Crip neighborhoods. But a lot of the dudes that was claiming Blood is because Lil Wayne, Juelz Santana, Jim Jones. Like, we really wasn't that. But I will say there was one kid named Peter. Peter was like that. Like, Peter would come to the school with the spring book bag with it on him. I remember one time the principal came, took his sidekick. Yo, he was barking at her. And we looking at him like, yo, Peter is crazy. Like, we knew nothing. Nobody would fuck with Peter. That's one nigga. But let me get back to Javier. So, again, it's Crips in the school. Everyone is scared of Javier. Like, Javier is the new Peter because Peter got kicked out. So now everyone is scared of Javier. There was two kids like that, Javier and Garfield. But everyone is scared of Javier, so no one is gonna say nothing to him. It's to the point now, Javier's coming up with a new team. He's making up a new group in the school. He's recruiting us. I get down. The group was called 044HB. So it was basically 044 Homicide Brothers. I don't even know if I knew a Homicide meant at the time. But like, I never had to explain it to me. Like, you know, I'm down. I joined. We had our own little handshake. Everybody had their own name. Blah, blah, blah. That's what it was. It was dope. Like, we really was kind of in sync. And then, like, I, like, looking back, like, he really, how he, like, we had, like, code signals. Like, it was a way to join. So I'm not going to lie. He was advanced. Like, he kind of had it all mapped out and set up to where he knew. Like, that was kind of crazy. So we all get down. It's to the point where we're making noise. Like, everybody's fake wanting to get down. But he's limiting it to for real. You know what I mean? Now, this where the story. There's a lot going on between us, but I'm going to speed it up. This where things get a little interesting. Javier and Angel getting so cool. Because remember, they're Dominican. We all in the same little gang or group or whatever you want to call it. Because we're not banging on people. It's like, yeah, we're claiming HD and Homicide. But it ain't like we walking around terrorizing the school. We're not doing that. It's like we're claiming this and we're just around. But if niggas want a problem, we supposed to form together and pull up. Like, well, what we on? That's the vibes. But we not, oh, we HB, we gonna wanna go fuck up like that. That wasn't what we was on. But it's like Angel and Javier is chilling outside of school though. Like, I'm not really chilling with these niggas outside of school. Cause I got my own other clique of friends and these two niggas are chilling outside of school though. So it's like, okay, I don't know if they lived in the same area, they take the same bus, whatever. So I remember this is one day, cause again, AIM is popping. AIM, Yahoo Messenger, MSN. I remember one day I'm on AIM and I see Javier on his status like, yo, I can't trust everybody. Fuck niggas, niggas be buns. So we confused. Cause again, like, this is the popular, this is the cool kid. So it's like, you know, we gonna check his AIM, we gonna check his status real quick. We on that sidekick, we scrolling, we wanna see everybody's status, see everybody away message. You know we gonna check Javier shit. This nigga Javier, he writing subs. So we try to figure, you know, next day of school come. We link up at the lunch table, like, cause you know, like, we ain't getting into, I don't know, like, for some reason, we ain't find out till lunch, huh? Like, I don't know why. Now we in lunch. I think a few niggas know, but like, we ain't had a big, like, it didn't get exposed for real till lunch. So we in the lunchroom. And Javier like, yeah, like, this nigga ran on me. He ain't do nothing, da da da. What? So basically what I learned is that I guess Javier and Angel was on a bus together in some hood. I think it was in the stop. And basically, I guess niggas fronted on Javier on the bus. Cause I guess he had a watch. I guess niggas wanted his watch. I don't remember what it was, but niggas fronted on him. And he like, cause in retrospect, cause I don't think Javier got it on. But at the same time, he looking like, my mans ain't get it on with me. Like, my mans ain't pop it. Looking back in retrospect as a grown man, I'm not popping nothing for no nigga if he not popping it. Now, unless it's like, niggas is fronting on him and they got the one up and they not paying attention to me and I can get like a little sneaky hit, cool. But if we both in front of them and they both, I'm not popping if you not popping. So I don't really know how the situation went looking back in retrospect, but from what the narrative that niggas was painting to me is that Angel could have did something and he chose not to. Like, he fake act like he ain't see bro getting robbed. That was the narrative that was painted to me. So niggas was like, nah, I'm not fuck with. But now here's the crazy thing though. And I probably should have told this part earlier, but I'm going off the, you know, fuck the fly. It was intense because remember, these niggas is cool. These niggas is so cool. Javier done fuck Angel cousin. Yeah. He done fuck Angel cousin. And Angel was with it. Angel fake set it up. You feel me? So now, once they stopped jacking each other, Javier wasn't really jacking the cousin. This the thing. Javier was treating Angel cousin as if she was a Tatiana. A treat. So I was never really thinking nothing of it because I never seen her. I don't know her. I never met her. I didn't. But now I don't know. And now looking back, I didn't think of this, but we all get cool again. Javier get cool with Angel again. But as time go by, Angel try to put me on to his cousin now. And looking back, it's like, damn, Angel, you treating your cousin like a thot for real. But again, we eighth grade kids. We not thinking nothing of it. He probably so hyped, like, yeah, my cousin look good. Like, look, he probably was using her as a way to get cool with niggas. Like, yeah, I'm putting you on to my cousin. Like, she look good, right? Like, he was really using her like that. You know what I mean? So we like, hell yeah, she looks good. Keep in mind, she was in 10th grade. We was in eighth grade. So she's really older than us. And she really is a thot because she knew I was cool with Javier. It didn't matter to her though. Right? Fast forward. I start fucking with Marlene. I get the little AIM, the little MSN. We start texting now. Whoa. Spicy. Come in. It's to the point. Yo, we're on MSN every day. Like, we're video chatting. Like, my brother and my big sister is in the back. They're like, yo, like, I'm like, look, guys, like, look. Like, I'm so hyped to just show them that I'm talking to a girl. Like, mind you, the girl is Hispanic, big titties, long hair. So I'm just so hyped to brag. Mind you, again, I'm like 14, 13. So in my kid brain, I'm that nigga. Like, you can't. La la, wait till I get my money. But you really can't tell me nothing. Like, I'm feeling like that bull. You know what I mean? Now, here's the thing though. I never went on a date prior. Like, I've never been, like, up to that point, again, I was in what, Avery? I've never been on a date with a female though. So now it's like the girl wants to meet me. And it's like, oh shit. I'm like, all right, we talking. Cause it's to the point now, it's like, we're MSN video chatting like 2 months straight and we haven't seen each other. So it's like, we want to meet each other. I'm like, all right. How we doing this? Oh, you should come over by me. Oh, we can figure it. We got it. So like, all right, cool. Now, keep in mind, at the time where I live and where my middle school is, I only have to take the bus. God. I only have to take the bus. I don't have to take the train. I'm in eighth grade. I've never had to take the train by myself anywhere. I've never had to do that. I'm in eighth grade. At my school, like, my school was always in bus or walking distance. So now, I am about to take the train to go link someone in a, like, so I'm kind of nervous. But it's like, all right, I'm feeling so bad to meet this girl that it's like, fuck it. I remember this day vividly. I get out of school. You know, we make that. So now here's the thing. Around that time, when I would get out of school, me and a lot of my friends, we either would do two things. Either we would go to the park and we'll play basketball, typical young black bullshit. Go play basketball so you get all sweaty, dirty fucking shoes that your parents worked hard to buy. You come home all sweaty and hungry. Or at the time we was going to the library. And at the library, you would get on the computer, you would play games, CartoonNetwork.com, whatever, you would play games. Or, we young niggas, a lot of us would play Yu-Gi-Oh! You know, we had the computer, we had the table, we playing Yu-Gi-Oh! With the calculator, like, it was real, man. We had the little sleeves and, yeah. Because where the library was at, there was a spot up the block that sold Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards, the real deal. You know, the gold emblem on the back, like, chill, like, real deal. So it was like, oh my God, like, you know? So typically after school, my parents or my family would know, like, all right, if he hasn't been home yet, he's probably playing basketball, he's probably at the library. On this particular day, I'm going to meet Jordy. So it's like, obviously I don't tell anybody. I don't even... I had to have had a cell phone at the time. I'm like, did I even have a phone? I don't even I'm not sure. I had to have had a phone, but there's no way. But I remember, I get on the bus, boom, take it to the train. I get on the train. Now, for my New York niggas, I had to take. I managed to get on Broadway. I had to take the L, Broadway Junction. Then from Broadway Junction, I had to take the A. Now, I am in eighth grade. I'm on Broadway Junction. I've heard infamous stories, so I'm just on point. Like, I'm looking around over my shoulder, walking down the stairs. I'm just so hyped, though, thinking how I'm about to meet this girl. Like, walk down the stairs, go, get on the train, go, boom. I get out the A train, I see Boys and Girls High School, walk down the block, couple blocks. I get on this girl, my heart is pumping as I'm walking to, like, pump, 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 like, it's pumping, bro. Mind you, at the time, I don't know, I definitely had a phone. You know what I'm listening to right now? At the time, I'm walking with my sidekick in my hand, and I'm playing Drake's Lust for Life. Houston, Land of Vegas, like, I'm walking to her block listening to this with my sidekick in my hand, no headphones. Because it's just like, that was the album or the music that was really penetrating at the time, and it's just like, that was the vibe, like, I'm trying to do it all for life. I got plans. I'm trying to, like, I'm just feeling like it's helping me feel confident. Like, yeah, like, this is what I waited for. Like, I get to the block, building open. I stand in the hallway. I text her, like, yo, I'm here. No response. Yo, I'm here. All right, she responds now. Give me a few minutes. Yo, I kid you not, a few minutes, I didn't know a few minutes was 30. The girl took 30 minutes, like, in my kid brain, that was an hour. Like, I don't know where I'm at. I walked past mad hood niggas coming here. I don't know if this is a setup. I don't know what I'm seeing. I'm standing in the building. I'm seeing spit, cigarette, backward guts, like, at the time, I'm not even a smoker yet. So it's like, I'm not in my habitat. I'm far from home. My people's probably looking for me. And in retrospect, like, I wasn't even really gonna do nothing for real because I was so shy and so scary that it was like, even, you know what I mean? Even if the opportunity presented itself, I wasn't gonna really do nothing crazy, you know? Maybe kissing and touching at the most. So I really was risking it all, but these are the things that a young brother gotta go through. A young brother gotta, you know what I mean? Some people don't never have these stories, and they don't ever go through those, so they don't never know how to maneuver later in life. You feel me? It's like, I'm grateful and I'm blessed for these little, you know? But long story short, she comes down, bobbing with her. My cousin is lingering around in the hallway, going in and out the apartment. I'm bobbing with her, talking with her. And it's just like, I'm just nervous because the girl is so super confident. Like, I heard that she done slopped my man, gave my man sloppy toppy, my man Javier and all that. So it's like, she's a confident girl. It's like, I'm nervous, you know what I mean? So it's like, damn, you know, but fast forward, man, we chopped it up, vibe, and it was a good vibe, but I definitely had to rush to leave. Because now at this time, let's say if school get out at like 2:20, my nigga, it's probably like 5:30. It's my dudes don't know where I'm at. Sister don't know where I'm at. But don't know. Like, I gotta get going. So I'm asking her, like, yo, you know, like, she's like, where you live? And she gave me the whole route. She's like, nah, you can take this bus, take it to that. Yo, long story short, all I had to do was walk down the block from her house, take the B15, and it literally dropped me down the block from my house. So all of that, Broadway Junction, traveling over it, risking my, looking over my, I really didn't have to do any of that. I could have took one bus from my house and it would have, so that was the crazy part. You know what I mean? So I end up leaving, get on the bus, go home. My nigga, when I get off the bus, guess who I see? My mom, my sister looking for me, like, and then just walking around looking for me, like just walking. I see them together, like, they was like across the street from my building, but you could tell that they was on a search for me. So as I see them through my peripheral, through the corner of my eye, they don't see me yet. So I'm trying to make up a story as I'm walking. I only know I have 20 seconds before they see me. I'm literally trying to make up, I lied and said I seen one of my mom's old friends, man. I had to just make a penny. Like, yeah, I seen Arnold. Like, I ain't believe that shit, man. You know what I mean? But looking back, they were hot. I ain't gonna lie, they were hot, but they definitely was glad that I was safe, you know? Looking back, I really was a bitch ass nigga. And looking back, like, I think Javier felt the way too that I was talking to Marlene, because he would say little things like, hey, she gave me the illest sloppy, my nigga. You should try to get that too. Like he would say, like, he didn't come off as a hater, but he would say things like, damn, if you're my man, why are you telling me that though? You know what I mean? So, but I don't think he knew what my intentions were. So I don't think he knew that I was damn near in love. I think he thought I was just trying to go for the kill too, but I was damn near in love, my nigga. You know, but it ended up not going too far with Marlene, you know. She was just too advanced for me, though. You know, and I knew that. She knew that, you know. So, you know, like, it just wasn't it, you know. But, like I said, I'm grateful for that type of thing, though, you know, because it just molded my character. It's a beautiful moment in history that just, it's so funny, and I hold dearly to my heart, you know, because it's like, you know, like, it's just a time capsule. Like, the social media platforms we was using at the time, you know, joining this little gang, this little brotherhood with my friends, and traveling, taking the train, and you know, it's just a deep experience, you know, because it basically was my first time traveling to see a girl, traveling to a different neighborhood, you know, and it's just things that I just never forget, because it's time, I didn't even know where I was at, where the girl lived, to be honest, but it's like, you know, in life where, like, you pass somewhere, and then you come back, and you cross that place again in life, and you're like, oh, shit, I've been here before, like, that kept happening to me with that, you know, so I ended up kept passing that location as time went on, you know, but I never seen a girl ever again in life to this day, you know, I was, like, 13 at the time, I've never seen her again, I haven't seen her social media profile, none of that, you know, if I was to guess, man, she probably pregnant with, like, 2-3 kids, probably then. You know what I mean? Like, she was a different type of girl, man. You know, but shout outs to Marlene, man. I don't know where Javier is at. I gotta look for him because I know his name too. I think at one point he had moved to like Long Island or Jersey or some shit. He got more into that gang shit. Like he became Blood, I guess, and he started to get more deep into that shit, you know. And like I kind of had to stray away a little bit because it's like he still, you know, it's like you doing that and you all the way over there, and it's like we don't even link, bro. And like I wasn't really on it like that. I'm gonna be honest, like. I fake was jacking shit. Like, I'm not really trying to go put in pain, though. You know? So, he just straight away. Angel, same thing I was saying. I bumped into Angel one time during high school times. Like, I bumped into him on the train. That was dope, you know? But, I haven't seen him after that, you know? Hopefully, everybody's good, man. Hopefully, everybody is blessed, you know? But, yes, story time. It's the first one with your boy Blesso, man. You know, some of these are gonna be real long, some of these are gonna be real short. To me, this is kind of short, it's like a decent size, but definitely gonna have a lot of good story times for y'all, man, because the people need it, man. I know what I'm doing right now, I know what I'm presenting, and it's gonna be powerful, you know, so just stick with me and rock out. Sure.